بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فالحمد لله. Today visiting us was our two brothers, Abu Muhammad al-Maghribi, حفظه الله تعالى, and likewise our brother Farid Abdullah, حفظه الله. And alhamdulillah, they offered valuable pieces of advice, and Allah Azza wa Jalla bless us to benefit from them and implement them. العلم والعمل معا. So for this closing session, alhamdulillah, likewise, we have our brother Abu Hassan Malik with us. The brothers are just going to give, inshallah, a few pieces of advice, starting with Farid, bi'idhnillah, he's on my right. Jazakallahu khairan. So inshallah, we request from the brothers to listen attentively. Barakallahu feekum.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو عابر سبيل. الله سبحانه وتعالى, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, did I say Allah إنما الله وإنما إليه راجعون. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم said, see, this is what happens when you get late and you start, your mind starts to hack up on you. Barakallahu feekum. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, be in this dunya as if you were a stranger or a traveler. يقول ابن رجب رحمه الله تعالى وصى النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم ابن عمر أن يكون في الدنيا على أحد هذين الحالين. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم commanded ابن عمر to be in one of two states. فأحدهما أن ينزل المؤمن نفسه كأنه غريب في الدنيا يتخيل الإقامة لكن في بلد غربة. The first is that the believer sees himself in the dunya but in a strange land. فهو غير متعلق القلب ببلد الغربة. So his heart is not connected with this strange land. بل قلبه متعلق بوطنه الذي يرجع إليه. But his heart is connected with his home where he intends to go. وإنما هو مقيم في الدنيا ليقضي مرمة جهاز إلى الرجوع إلى وطنه. And he only resides in this dunya until he can repair his gear to return home. والحالة الثانية, the second condition, أن ينزل المؤمن نفسه في الدنيا كأنه مسافر. The second state is that he considers himself as a traveler. غير مقيم البتة. He doesn't even reside, he just continues his journey. وإنما هو سائر في قطع منازل السفر حتى ينتهي به السفر إلى آخره وهو الموت. But he continues his journey and he completes his destination without stopping until it ends with death. ومن كانت هذه حاله, ومن كانت هذه حاله في الدنيا فمهمته وهمته تحصيل زاد للسفر. the person who has this stake in the dunya, his aim is simply to get the provisions necessary to continue his travel. وَلَيْسَ هِمَّتُهُ فِي الْإِسْتِكْثَارِ مِنْ مَتَاعِ الدُّنْيَا, and not to store up things of this life. قَالَ فُضَيْلِ بْنُ عِيَادٍ لِرَجُلٍ كَمْ أَتَدْ عَلَيْكَ. Fudayl ibn Uyad once said to a man, how old are you? How many years have come upon you? قَالَ سَتُونَ سَنَةً. He said, 60 years. قَالَ فَأَنْتَ مُنْذُ سِتِينَ سَنَةً تَسِيرُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يُوشِكْ أَنْ تَبْلُكَ. For 60 years, you were traveling towards your Lord, and pretty soon you shall arrive. فَقَالَ رَجُلْ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. The man said, Inna lillahi, we belong to Allah, and to him shall we return. فَقَالَ الْفُضَيْلِ أَتَعْرِفْ تَفْسِيرَهُ. Do you know the meaning of this? تَقُولْ أَنَا لِلَّهِ عَبْدٌ وَإِلَيْهِ رَاجِعٌ. You're saying that I'm a slave of Allah, and to him I shall return. فَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ لِلَّهِ عَبْدٌ وَأَنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعٌ فَلْيَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ. And whoever knows and he understands that he's a slave of Allah and to him he shall return, know that you shall be made to stand before your Lord. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ فَلْيَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ. And know that if you shall be made to stand up, that you shall be questioned. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ فَلْيُعِدَّ لِلسُّؤَالِ جَوَابًا. And if you know that you shall be questioned, then prepare a response for that time. فَقَالَ الرَّجُلْ فَمَا الْحِيلَ. The man says, what is the way out? Fudayl says, يَسِيرَ, it is very simple. مَا هِيَ, what is it? قَالَ تُحْسِنْ فِيمَا بَقِيَ يُكْفَرْ لَكَ مَا مَضَى. He said, do good in what remains in your life, and you shall be forgiven for what passed. وقد أخذ عبد الله بن عمر من قول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فكان يقول. عبد الله بن عمر took from this advice of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he used to say, إذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح. If you happen to reach the evening, don't expect to make it to the morning. وإذا أصبحت فلا تنتظر المساء. And if you arrive upon the morning, don't expect to make it to the evening time. خُذْ مِنْ صِحَتِكَ لِمَرَضِكَ وَمِنْ حَيَاتِكَ لِمَوْتِكَ. Take from the time of your health when you shall be sick and ill, and from your life and prepare to die. Prepare for your death. قال ابن رجب وَأَمَّا وَصِيَّةُ ابْنِ عُمَرَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا فَهِيَ مَأْخُوذَةٌ مِنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ. The advice of Ibn Umar is taken from this particular hadith. وَهِيَ مُتَضَمِّنْ لِنِحَيَةِ قِسَرِ الْأَمَلِ. And what it involves is that you do not have a hope for a long life. A limited hope concerning a long life. وَأَنَا الْإِنسَانِ إِذَا أَمْسَى. And if you get up in the evening, don't expect to make it to the morning. Likewise, if you make it in the morning, don't expect to make it otherwise. بَلْ يُذُنُّ أَنَّ أَجَلَهُ يُذُرِكُ قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ. But he thinks that perhaps death will meet him before that time. وَبِهَذَا فَصَّرَ غَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ مِنَ الْعُلَمَاءَ الزُّهْدِ فِي الدُّنْيَا. And this is how many of the scholars of old interpreted or they explained what zuhud is, being austere in the world. One of the scholars said to Imam Ahmad, Ayyu shayna zuhd? What is zuhd? What is zuhd in this dunya? Qala qisr al-amal. That you don't think that you shall live long. And whoever gets up in the morning, let him think that he might not make it to the evening. Wa hakadha qala Sufyan. Ma'un ibn Abdullah قال ما أنزل الموت كنه منزله من عد غدا من أجله. A person really has not placed death in his life in the consciousness of himself truly if he considers tomorrow as a part of his lifespan. كم من مستقبل يوم لم يستكمله؟ How many people begin a new day and never complete it? But كم من مؤمل لغد لا يدركه? And how many people desire to see tomorrow, they shall not attain that? He said, وَلَوْ رَأَيْتَ الْأَجَلَ وَمَسِيرَهُ لَبْغَتُمُ الْأَجَلَ وَغُرُورَهُ. If you see what the lifespan is like and the hope for a long life, you would begin to hate it. وكان يقول أحد السلف إن من أنفع أيام المؤمن له في الدنيا ما ظن أنه لا يدرك آخره. The most beneficial day in the believer's life is that day when he thinks he's not going to see tomorrow, or he will not see the end of that day. كتب الأوزاعي لأخ له. أوزاعي wrote to one of his brothers and he said to him, أما بعد فقد أحيط بك من كل جانب. You have become surrounded from all sides. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ يُسَارُ بِكَ فِي كُلِّ يَوْمَ لَيْلًا. And that you've been driven each day and night, taken forth. فَحْذُرِ اللَّهِ. Be mindful of Allah. وَالْمَقَامَ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ. And standing in front of Him. وَهِنْ يَكُونَ آخِرُ أَحْدِكَ بِهِ. And let your last covenant be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والسلام. يقول بعض السلف نسير إلى الأجال في كل لحظة أيامنا تطوى بهن مراحل لم أرى مثل الموت حقا كأنه إذا مات خطته الأماني باطل ما أقبح التفريط في زمن الصبا فكيف به والشيب للرأس شامل ترحل من الدنيا بزاد من التقى فعمرك أيامهن قلائل. نسير إلى الأجال في كل لحظة. Every moment we travel to our end. أيامنا تطوى وهن مراحل. Our days becoming short. And only a few miles left. ولم أرى مثل الموت حقا كأنه إذا مات خطته أماني الباطل. I have seen nothing like death, a reality. Once the hope of a long life traverses upon its path, it's as if it doesn't even exist. ما أقبح التفريط في زمن الصبا. How evil is negligence at the time of your youth. فكيف به والشيب للرأس شامل. How much more an evil when white has covered the whole head. ترحل من الدنيا بزاد من التقى. Leave this dunya with a provision of righteousness. فعمرك أيامهن قلائل. Because your life for a small number of days, your life are nothing but days, and they are but few. هذه يكفينا. بارك الله فيك.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. جزا الله خيرا أستاذنا وأخانا الفاضل أبا مجاهد الفريد عبد الله وجعل ما قدم في ميزان حسناته خالصا له يوم نلقى الله ووجد منا آذانا ساغية وقلوبا واعية ونفعنا به. We ask Allah to reward our brother حفظه الله فريد عبد الله جزاه الله خير for the efforts that he put to propagate the da'wah, to call the people to the sunnah upon the understanding of As-Salaam As-Saleh. We ask Allah to preserve him and protect him and keep him and all of us upon the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah to save this humble effort for him and his skills of good deeds sincerely for him when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as for us, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that these words doesn't fall on deaf ears, like they say, or go one ear and go out the other, but rather we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who understood them correctly and put them to practice. Because that's the reason from these seminars and from these classes, is for us to pay attention to what is said, and let every one of us correct himself and do the work we need to do. وإني أحمد الله أني وافقت أخي مرة أخرى. And I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that subhanAllah, without any further planning, I agree with him again on the same topic we also talk about. Just like that, alhamdulillah. I said what I'm going to say. They said a reminder. I said, I have the book of Shaykh Nur al-Amin. This is the book of our noble scholars we learn from, alhamdulillah, and we share the information. An-Nawawi, Riyad al-Salihin, of An-Nawawi, rahimahullah, باب فضل الزهد في الدنيا والحث على التنقل منها وفضل الفقر. And this is a chapter that highlight the virtue of zuhd in the dunya. And we heard what the Imam Ahmed says about zuhd, alhamdulillah, in this life. And that we should not make it our concern and our goal and our target and our objective. Take from it what we need. And yet, poverty has virtues. And Nawawi, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned many ayats as in Riyad al-Salihin. He mentioned ayats from the Book of Allah and a hadith from the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Shaykh ibn al-Haymin, أبي عبد الله محمد بن صالح العثيمين رحمه الله تعالى وغفر له ولوالديه وللمسلمين والمسلمات آمين is one of the great scholars of our time in this era. He has left a great treasure for the Muslims. His books, alhamdulillah, his classes are on the YouTube, on the internet. He has a website, alhamdulillah, and channels, radio channel, and the like. This is a alim, a scholar that have left a lot for the Muslims, has dedicated his life into teaching in many fields of the deen, many fields, from the Arabic and the tafsir and the hadith, and the aqeedah, the tawheed, the akhlaq, the adab, the manhaj, the raqa'iq. Choose any topic. Jazahullahu khaira wa rahimahullah. Qala rahimahullah. Qala al-mu'allif, yani al-Nawawi rahimahullah, babu fadli al-zuhdi fi al-dunya wa al-hathi ala al-taqalluli minha wa fadli al-faqr. A chapter dealing with having zuhd in this dunya that we live in. And also that we be from those people who take from it a little. And also in this chapter we'll highlight the virtues of faqr, poverty. قال الدنيا هي حياتنا هذه التي نعيش فيها. It says here in Nawawi, what he intended by the dunya is the life that we live in. وسمي الدنيا لسببين. He says he was called dunya for two reasons. السبب الأول أنها أدنى من الآخرة لأنها قبلها كما قال تعالى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. He says because it is less in degree than the آخرة, than the life of the hereafter. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Duha, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى, that the life of the hereafter is better for you than the one that came before it, his life on earth. والسبب الثاني لماذا سميت الدنيا دنيا لأنها دنيئة ليست بشيء بالنسبة للآخرة. It was called dunya also because compared to the akhirah it's like nothing. كما روى الإمام أحمد رحمه الله من حديث المستورد بن شداد that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says لموضع صوت أحدكم في الجنة خير من الدنيا وما فيها. For indeed the place of his sword. The place of a whip of one of you in the Jannah is better than the dunya and what's in it. للدنيا. قال موضع يعني موضع العصا القصيرة في الجنة، إن الجنة خير من الدنيا وما فيها من أولها إلى آخرها. It's better than what's in the dunya. The dunya and all what's in it from the beginning until the end. قال هذه هي الدنيا. So it's important, Ikhwan, for us to take from it, take from the dunya, the zad, as we've been hearing, alhamdulillah, especially today, and also in the talks that was in Masjid al-Rahmah, alhamdulillah, about the hereafter. We heard a lot of advices, alhamdulillah, statements that should help us and enable us to be serious and to think about that inevitable journey, to prepare ourselves for the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَنَحْنُ مَا خُلِقْنَا عَبَثًا وَلَمْ نُتْرَكْ حَمَلًا. الله سبحانه وتعالى خلقنا لغاية عظيمة هي عبادته سبحانه وتعالى. Because we were not created in vain for play, for no purpose, but rather we are created for a great purpose. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala بالتوحيد through Islamic monotheism. والله سبحانه وتعالى أرسل إلينا رسولا وأنزل عليه القرآن وقد بلغ الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الرسالة وأمرنا بالاتباع. الله سبحانه وتعالى has sent to us, to mankind, our beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as a bearer of glad tidings for those who obey him and act upon that which he brought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as a warner for those who reject his message. So it is incumbent upon us, Ikhwan, to always keep in mind the reason why we're here and why we're created. And we try to stick to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has chosen for his servants. صراط الله المستقيم في كل شيء. We hold on to the deen of Allah by learning it first and by taking knowledge from this deen of its proper sources, the book of Allah and the sound sunnah of the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the understanding of as-salaf as-salih. It's very important because there is no way for guidance and there is no way for success, there is no way for anyone to earn the pleasure of Allah except by adhering to that which the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim they were upon. ومفهوم المخالفة عند الأصوليين أن من لم يتبع سبيل الصحابة لا يكون مع الفائزين ولا يناله رضا الله سبحانه وتعالى ولا يكون مهتديا حقا. The علماء الأصول, they mention when they bring an ayah that talks about the reward of Allah, for instance, like the ayah in Surah At-Tawbah, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. الآيه, those foremost, the Muslims who accept Islam, from the Muhajirin and the Ansar, and those who follow them exactly in faith, in the Aqidah, in the Ibadat, in the Mu'amalat, in the Akhlaq, they adhere to the path of the Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim. Look at the benefits. Allah is pleased with them and they pleased with him. Allah prepared for them gardens of paradise. To the end of the ayah 100 in Surah At-Tawbah. The ulama, they mention also that the opposite is true. The one who does not follow what the companions they were upon in exactly, this person will not earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same way the other ayahs, who they mention he who adhere to them, which the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam they were upon, he will be guided. He will be upon the right path. Then those who do not adhere, مفهوم المخالفة أيضا, those who do not adhere to what the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim they were upon, then they will not be rightly guided. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us beneficial knowledge that is taken from its proper sources, the book of our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Qur'an al-Azim, Allah grant us the understanding of the book. But we have to make efforts. إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلُّمُ. And we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially those amongst us in this era. Not only that you find yourself, we find ourselves being, alhamdulillah, in Masjid of Ahlul Sunnah, who the Imam, the administration, all the Masajid of Ahlul Sunnah who are established upon these principles. They call to Tawheed, they warn against shirk. They call to Sunnah, warn against innovations. They call to the Akhlaq al-Fadila, and they warn against the low and base and wicked manners and ill manners. They attach the people to the ulama of Ahlul Sunnah, the ulama al-Rabbaniyin, and they warn against the fake ulama and those who want to take the people away from their ulama. Those who they create the path of innovation and desires, and they want to take the Muslims away from the path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for them. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that, but we have to benefit from it. We have to be serious, ya akhwan. We have a lot of information, and especially in our times, as Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahu ta'ala, in his time, he died some 15 years ago, rahimahullah. And he says, alhamdulillah, this internet and this technology is a ni'mah from Allah. If it's used properly, use it to learn, to spread the knowledge, the deen of Allah. Since he died, rahimahullah, look how much technology we have now. If we use it properly, alhamdulillah, this deen is very accessible. You can now learn while you're driving. Before you have a book, you cannot read a book while you're driving. That's not even safe. Shouldn't even do it. But now you have an MP3, you have those USBs right around. I have to plug it. You don't even have to download it. You have it in your smartphone. And as you're going to work, it takes you half an hour. Put Sheikh Ibn Baz's class on Fadlu al-Ilm, Fadlu kalimat al-Tawheed, the virtue of the statements of Tawheed, the meaning of La ilaha illallah, the meaning of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have CDs, you have that MP3 that is loaded with the statements of the Sheikh al-Albani, the classes of Sheikh Ibn Baz, the classes of Sheikh Uthaymeen, Sheikh al-Fawzan, Sheikh Rabi, Sheikh Ahmed al-Nazmi, Sheikh Muqbil, Sheikh Zayd al-Madkhali, Sheikh Ubaid, and Sheikh Muhammad al-Hadi, and the Mashayikh of Ahlul Sunnah, al-Jama'ah, and the students of knowledge who they follow their path and call the people to that which the ulama they call to. And I'm sure if we do this, subhanAllah, our life is going to change. We're going to, because through knowledge, even if you're stuck in the traffic, mom, you're not even going to notice that you're in the traffic, because your mind is something else. You go for a dentist appointment, whatever it is, they tell you, wait, I said, alhamdulillah, Allah given more time to finish this chapter. أُقْدُوا سَاعَاتِ الْإِنْتِظَارِ بِالْإِسْتِغْفَارِ. Not by complaining, why me, why not, يَا أَخِي أُذْكُرِ اللَّهِ. Listen to that class, finish it. And also we invite others to the good. You listen to something good, spread it. هَكَدَ يَنْتَشِرَ الْعِلْمِ وَيَنْتَشِرَ الْخَيْرِ. This is how knowledge will spread. This is how the khair will spread. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us with that which we gain from the ulama. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala Muhammad ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa sallam wa sallam.
Alhamdulillah, hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fih, كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد. أود الإخوان بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى to bring a piece of advice that was given by the noble Sheikh Ahmed al-Najmi رحمه الله تعالى. By Allah's permission, this weekend we have the opportunity to speak regarding the afterlife. And we read, Ya Akhwan, Allah yubarik feekum, from the hadith of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, an al-Bara' ibn Azib. The long narration regarding what happens after death in the grave from the three questions. And I wanted Ikhwan just to read quickly a tremendous piece of advice from Shaykh Ahmed al-Najmi in his explanation of Kitab al-Sunnah from the Sunnah of Abi Dawood, rahimahullah ta'ala. And this is regarding Ikhwan that when the believer dies and he is placed in his grave, and that angel comes to him and he says, Ma kunta ta'bud, what did you used to worship? And as Shaykh Abdul Muhsin mentions, Ikhwan, the one who was given tawfiq, that believer, he will say Allah. He will answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then it will be said to him, وَمَا تَقُولْ فِي هَذَا الرَّجُلِ, and what do you say regarding this man? Meaning Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he will say, Abdullah wa rasuluhu, the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. And he will receive, Ikhwan, from the na'im of the grave, from the pleasures of the grave. But as for the disbeliever, in the narration, when he is placed in his grave and that angel comes to him and says to him, Ma kunta ta'bud, what did you used to worship? And he will say, La adri. He will say, I don't know. And that angel will say to him, Ikhwan, as is found in the narration, Ma darait wa ma talait. You didn't know, as Shaykh Ahmed Najmi will explain, the meaning of you didn't know me, you didn't strive to know, you didn't try to learn, you didn't try to find out the answer that would give you the correct understanding. وَمَا تَلَيْتَ, and nor did you follow the people of righteousness, but rather you followed the people of shar, the people of evil, the people of shirk, the people of innovation. So the Shaykh, he says, Ikhwan, Shaykh Ahmed Najmi, معنى قوله لا دريت يعني أنك لم تبحث عما يدلك على الدراية. He said, you did not search after that which would point you in the direction of proper understanding. That which would give you proper understanding. لم تبحث على العلم الذي ينفعك. You did not search for knowledge that would benefit you. And what we understand from this, Ya Akhwan, Allah yubarik feekum, is that there is knowledge that does not benefit. For certainly the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the narration, he made dua, he supplicated Ikhwan, and sought a refuge from three things. And from them, Ya Ikhwan, ilmun la yanfa', from knowledge that does not benefit. From knowledge that does not benefit. And then Shaykh Ahmed Najmi, Ikhwan, he says, وَكَذَلِكَ لَمْ تَتْلُوا كِتَابَ اللَّهِ, and similarly, you did not read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّمَا حَرِسْتَ عَلَى غَيْرِهِ, but rather you were concerned with other than that. You were diligent in seeking other than that from knowledge. فَلِذَلِكَ عُقِبْتَ بِهَذِهِ الْمُعَاقَبَةِ, and therefore you have received this recompense. This is what you have been given because of your lack of concern, your lack of striving to find proper knowledge. لعدم اهتمامك بما ينفعك في آخرتك, because of your lack of concern for that which would benefit you in your afterlife. And then the Shaykh, he says, إخوان, وإنك لترى كثير من الناس اليوم يحرص على الجريدة يشتريها يوميا ويقرأ الأخبار التي فيها. And then the Shaykh says, you will see many today who are diligent to buy the newspaper every single day and to read what is found in that newspaper from information. Now, I mentioned this earlier, Ya Ikhwan, and I reiterate. The Shaykh is mentioning this how many years ago? That you will find the people, Ikhwan, and we know of a people who are so concerned, Ikhwan, with that which they find in the newspapers. And nowadays, Ikhwan, we find upon the internet, and we find upon the cell phones from social media, the people have lost their minds. And to the point where, Ikhwan, as we had mentioned earlier, a person wakes in the morning to social media. The first thing he does when he wakes in the morning is go to the social media websites. And the last thing he does before going to bed is go to the social media websites. Concerned with posting. concerned with scrolling. Where is his concern, ikhwan, with that knowledge that will benefit him or her for the akhirah? And this is something, ikhwan, that we should be concerned with our children as well. But we talked about this before, ikhwan, when the Messenger of Allah Muhammad asked that slave girl, in Allah, where is Allah? She said, fis sama', above the heavens. Shaykh al-Albani made a point. He said, this slave girl was far away from the circles and the sittings with the Messenger of Allah Muhammad. She was busy tending to the flock. But even her, ikhwan, being far away from those circles of learning, she understood the aqidah sahiha. She understood the correct creed in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many of us, ikhwan, have we asked our children right now to give us evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above his throne? How many of our children can give us one ayah or one hadith? How many of us, ya ikhwan, Allah yubarak fikum, could give one ayah or one hadith? So this ihtimam, this concern, this due diligence, ikhwan, is something that we must concern ourselves with. As the Shaykh said, not like those, ikhwan, who are diligent as it relates to the reading of the newspaper and finding out what is taking place therein. وَرُبَّمَا أَنَّهُ يَمُرْ عَلَيْهِ شَهْرٌ وَلَا يَفْتَحْ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. And he said, ikhwan, perhaps a month will pass this person and they did not open the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not one time. As we said, ikhwan, opening the cell phone, looking at what is on Facebook, opening the cell phone, looking at what is on Twitter, opening the cell phone, concerned about Instagram and the memes. But perhaps they have not opened the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a month, and that is being generous. Perhaps some have not opened the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for 6 months, or maybe since Ramadan. So we see, ya ikhwan, Allah yubarak fikum, the Shaykh is mentioning here, those who concern themselves with the daily actions or the daily activities of the newspaper, they do not open the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا يَقْرَأَهُ, and they don't read it, وَلَا يَتَأَمَّلْ فِيهِ, and they don't consider the Qur'an, they don't contemplate what is in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been commanded, ikhwan, to contemplate over the verses of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Shaykh, he says, فَهَذَا يُخَافَ عَلَيْهِ, the likes of this one, we fear for that person. And what do we say, ikhwan, about the person, as we said, who are so concerned with these things? And we're not exaggerating, ikhwan, that some people, ikhwan, are so concerned, so obsessed with these cell phones, ikhwan, that they don't concern themselves with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They haven't cracked Kitab al-Tawheed. They haven't cracked Sahih al-Bukhari. No, they haven't cracked the books of ilm, ya ikhwan, because they are obsessed with what is going on with social media. And then when you call them away from these things and you warn them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they say those brothers are extreme. Well, Shaykhana Shaykh Muqbil rahimahullah ta'ala, ya ikhwan, he made a tremendous point. It should not be said about a person that he is extreme, ikhwan, who warns from someone from that which is haram in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So someone says to you, ya akhi, riba is haram, interest is haram, don't deal in the interest. And they say to you, ya akhi, stop being extreme. Or you say to the person, you say to the woman, ya ukhti, you should cover yourself in the manner and the fashion that you have been commanded with. And the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not permissible for you to display your beauty in this manner. And the people, they say, this person is extreme. Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil rahimahullah ta'ala, ya ikhwan, he mentioned this is not being extreme. Rather, ikhwan, the people who do not understand obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are those who see this to be extreme. So the Shaykh says, we are concerned and we fear for the likes of this person. Because this is considered neglect of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعِنَايَ بِمَا لَا يَنْفَعُ, and concerning oneself with that which will not benefit them. أَيَكُنْ نَفِعُهُ قَلِيلًا, or the benefit of that thing, ikhwan, is very little. And sometimes the people say, ya akhi, I look upon the social media because I can find out what's going on with my relatives, I can find out what's going on with friends that I haven't seen in years. Now, so the Shaykh, he says, ikhwan, they concern themselves with that which is of no benefit or that which is of little benefit. فَإِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. وَاللَّهِ إِنَّكَ لَتَتَعَجَّلْ لَوَ أَعْتَيْتَ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمْ كِتَابٍ يَقْرَأَهُ يَنْتَفِعَ مِنْهُ فِي عَقِيدَتِهِ. وينتفع منه في تقوية إيمانه ربما أنه يأخذه منك ويرميه. The Sheikh, he says, rahimahullah ta'ala, ikhwan, you would be amazed at one of these individuals that if you were to give them a book to benefit from, you gave them a book, for example, in the aqidah, so they could benefit in the aqidah, or you give them a book, ikhwan, that may increase them in their iman, the Sheikh says perhaps they would take that book from you, and they would toss it to the side. Not even concern themselves with it, ikhwan. He says, وَلَا يَنْظُرْ فِيهِ, and not even look inside of the book, ikhwan. وَرُبَّمَا أَنَّهُ لَا يَخُضُهُ مِنْكَ وَلَا يَقْبَلُهُ مِنْكَ. And perhaps there are those who would not even take the book from you and would not even accept it. This, ikhwan, is because some of the people have become so obsessed, so concerned, ikhwan, as we have said, with that which goes on with social media. And that which goes on, ikhwan, on these phones and the likes of this, until the people, ikhwan, have neglected that which is found from knowledge in the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And sometimes, ikhwan, you find them with some of these yani means that even make mockery of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You find them laughing at memes, ikhwan, that make mockery of plural marriage, for example, or make mockery of affairs of covering proper dress of our sisters and the likes of this. You find the people yani passing these memes around and laughing at these memes. What is this, ya ikhwan, Allah yabarakikum? They have neglected the reading in the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the books of the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and concerning themselves with beneficial knowledge. And as we said, ikhwan, perhaps they would not even accept these books from you if you gave them to them. The Sheikh, he says in conclusion, وَإِنِّي لَأَدْعُوا هَؤُلَىٰ أَنْ يَعْتَنُوا بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ. He said, and I call them, I invite these individuals to concern themselves with the Book of Allah. وَأَنْ يَعْتَنُوا بِسُنَّةِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And that they concern themselves with the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَيَعْتَنُوا بِالَّذِي يَنْفَعَهُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And that they concern themselves with that which will be a benefit for them in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خَيْلَهُمْ مِنَ الْأَخْبَارِ الَّتِي لَا تُفِيدَ الْعَبْدِ فِي آخِرَتِهِ شَيْئًا. He said, it is better than that which they will find from this news that will be of no benefit for them in their afterlife. وَإِنَّمَا هِيَ لَهُمْ. And rather, ikhwan, it is empty speech and vain speech that the people have involved themselves in. وَإِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ وَبِاللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقِ. And the Shaykh says, from Allah we come and to Allah we return, and success is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. جزاكم الله خير.
الحمد لله رب العالمين, حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, I'd like to close with some words of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى, and I think it can summarize a lot of what has been said prior to me from the benefits, alhamdulillah, that we heard from our brothers. May Allah Azza wa Jalla reward them with good. Ameen. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, Kamal al-insan madaruhu ala aslain. The perfection of any individual revolves around two things. The perfection of any individual revolves around two things. Now every Muslim wants to better themselves. Every Muslim wants to better his family. So what are these two things that complete an individual? He said, ma'rifatu al-haq min al-batil, knowing truth from falsehood, al-ilm, wa itharuhu alayh, and giving preference to that knowledge of truth in implementation and action over everything else. Brothers and sisters, that is a very important statement. And there are many evidences to support that from the Book of Allah
and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To the extent that Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he divided the people into four categories as it pertains to these two foundational affairs. He said that al-Qism al-Awwal, the first group of people, ashrafuhum, the most noble of the creation, wa akramuhum inda Allah, and the most noble of those before Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And who are they? They are those who have knowledge of the truth and they implement it. They have al-quwwa fi ma'rifat al-haq min al-batil. They have strength in the area of knowing truth from falsehood. And likewise, they have quwwa fi tanfidihi, and they have the strength to implement it. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make us from amongst them.
Amen.
The second group of people, man la basira lahum fi ma'rifat al-haq. وَلَا قُوَّةَ عَلَى تَنْفِيذِ الْحَقِّ. Those who have no strength as it pertains to understanding the truth, they're weak in this area. And they are weak in the implementation of the truth, and they are the worst of the four categories. But Ibn al-Qayyim said, this category, أَكْثَرُ الْخَلْقِ, is the majority of the creation, and he described them as an eyesore, subhanAllah al-Azim. The third group of people, al-Qism al-Thalith, مَنْ لَهُ بَصِيرَةَ مَنْ لَهُ بَصِيرَةَ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ الْحَقِّ. He has knowledge as it pertains to knowing the truth, knowing what is guidance, recognizing truth from falsehood. لَكِنُّهُ ضَعِيف عَلَى تَنْفِيذِهِ. But he's weak in his implementation. He's weak in calling to it and inviting to it. He said, وَهَذَا حَالَ الْمُؤْمِنَ الضَّعِيفِ. And this is the condition of the weak believer. And that reminds us of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Min hadithi Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, الْمُؤْمِنَ الْقَوِي خَيْرٌ وَأَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنَ الضَّعِيفِ وَفِي كُلٍ خَيْرٌ. The strong believer, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen said, strength here is a sifat of what? An attribute of the believer in terms of iman, not physical strength. Al-mu'min al-qawi. The strong believer is better and more beloved to Allah than the weak believer, and in both of them are good. But listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said next. Advice, golden advice. احرص على ما ينفعك واستعين بالله ولا تعجز. Focus upon what is beneficial to you. Focus upon seeking knowledge and acting upon that knowledge and going in search of that knowledge. Focus upon your creed. Focus upon learning about your prayer. Focus about learning your religion. Focus upon that. وَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. Do not think you can do it alone. Seek the aid of Allah Azza wa Jal. And do not be lazy. Do not be lazy. Brothers and sisters, the way of the Salaf, if we look at them and their diligence in seeking knowledge, from the Sahaba onwards, لا مثال له. And this slot here, the slot that we have, is normally for Kitab al-Tawheed. And I always encourage the brothers and the sisters to be diligent in learning their religion. Learn the Arabic language. Because the Arabic language is the key to understand the Quran and the Sunnah. Learn the sciences of the religion. We need du'at. We need callers. We need scholars. More than we need chemists. More than we need doctors. More than we need lawyers. One of the Salaf, he said, دين النبي محمد أخبار نعم المطية للفتاء آثار لا ترغبن عن الحديث وأهله فالرأي ليل والحديث نهار ولربما جهل الفتى سبل الهدى والشمس بازغة ولها أنوار. He said what? دين النبي محمد أخبار. The religion of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is narrations, ahadith. قال الله, قال رسول الله, قال الصحابة. That is what you find in the sittings of the people of the Sunnah. What a great means. This is for the young person who learns these things.
لا ترغبن عن الحديث وأهله. Don't turn away from the seeking the hadith, knowledge of the hadith, and who? The people of hadith. If you find their gatherings, even if you have to ride on the back of a camel, get on that camel and find them and go and sit with them. ولربما جهل الفتى سبل الهدى والشمس بازغة ولها أنوار. It's possible that the young person, he may be unaware of the path of guidance, but the sun is clear in the sky and it has rays. The sun is clear in the sky. What? The sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. تركتكم على البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. I've left you upon clear guidance. Its night is like its day. No one deviates from it except that they are destroyed. القسم الرابع, the fourth group of people, as mentioned by Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. له قوة وهمة. He has strength and determination. على تنفيذ الحق, to act and implement the truth. He has a thirst to implement the truth. ولكنه ضعيف البصيرة. But he's weak in his understanding of the religion. سبحان الله العظيم. He's weak in his understanding of the religion. Do you know what Ibn al-Qayyim, and this is a summary of his words, and I advise the brothers and sisters to return back to them for a precise quotation of those words. He said, يكاد أحدهم لا يميز بين أولياء الشيطان وأولياء الرحمن. He said, you will find one of them. They can almost never distinguish between the allies of the devil and the allies of the most merciful. They're always confused. How many people are like that in this time? How many people are confused? أخي من يعني مصيب في هذه المسألة? Who's correct in this? Who's right? من المخطي? Who's incorrect? Look at القسم الرابع. He has قوة and همة. Subhanallah, that's the one who has قوة. He has the determination and the zeal to do good. He wants to act. He acts in implementation of what he knows. ولكنه ضعيف البصيرة. He's weak in his understanding of the religion. He's weak in his understanding of the religion. So this person, Ibn al-Qayyim, he said, يَكَادُ أَحَدُهُمْ, you will find that almost they can nearly never distinguish between the awliya of Allah and the awliya of the shaitan. Always confused. Who's right? Who's wrong? And then all they can mention, oh, this sheikh, he said this. This sheikh, he said that. And you're left with just statements of mashayikh. What do I do? I'll give an example. Brother Fareed was there, alhamdulillah, from amongst min ikhwan and our brothers, and I'll close with this. The brothers, jazamullah khair, and had a small dispute about the issue of how to line up, whether you join the ankles or you don't join the ankles. And one of the brothers said, well, Sheikh, Fulan said such and such, rahimahullah. The other brother said, well, Sheikh, Fulan said such and such, hafidhahullah. So I asked the brother a question. Whose statement do we give precedence over the statement of everyone else? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What does he say? Brothers and sisters, if we want to avoid being confused, if we want a way out from al-fitan, we have to learn our religion. I don't want you to have to wait for me to translate a book. I want you to be able to read that book for yourself. I don't want you to have to be rely upon someone else. If we make a mistake, inshallah, we want brothers, we want even sisters to correct us. Shaykhana Shaykh Muqbir rahimahullah ta'ala, that was his way. دائما كان يكرر. He always used to repeat, I don't call any of you to blind follow me. Wallahi, we don't call any of the brothers and sisters to blind follow any of us. We are not deserving to be blind followed. If Ibn Abbas, he said, I say to you, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and you say to me, Abu Bakr said and Umar said, I fear that stones will fall upon you from the heavens. How can you blind follow masakeen like us? Subhanallah al-Azim. The Sheikh, he said, I want you to be writers. This was the students, encouragement to his students always. I want you to be writers. I want you to be researchers. I want you to be strong in grammar. I want you to be strong in hadith. Don't blind follow my ruling on the hadith. Get the tool so you can go away and learn it. Ikhwan, should we not have this attitude when we're learning our religion? This is our deen, it's precious. Turn away from the qeel and qal. He said, she said. He's talking about this one. She's talking about that one. Who cares? Let's focus on learning our religion. Sufyan al-Thawri, he said, Al-Isnad Silah al-Muslim, فَإِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ مَعُوا سِلَاحْ فَبِأَيِّ شَيْنْ يُقَاتِلْ. The Isnad, ilm al-hadith, knowledge of the religion is the weapon of the believer. If you don't have that weapon, what do you fight with? Just your emotions? Or I like you, so I'm going to walk with you. Or I dislike you, so I'm going to turn away from you. It's too much kalam, ikhwan, in this time. But alhamdulillah, there's a major task ahead. We have our children, we have our families, we have our brothers, we have our sisters. But alhamdulillah, the opportunity is great. The da'wah is spreading in the face of all of these challenges, alhamdulillah. And the tawfiq is from Allah Azza wa Jal, not from any of us. But alhamdulillah, we can make it better. They need brothers to give khutbah. Abu Muhammad said to me today, the brothers in Florida, they're looking for an imam. We need qualified individuals. This is not an exclusive club. No, we want more brothers to be qualified and to be wise in their approach to the da'wah. We want brothers to be better than us. Let's not be shay, we're nothing. Brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, let's get serious in learning and being, inshallah, a'wan, encouragements for one another and supporting one another. Inna wa jazakum Allahu khayran wa barakallahu feekum wa faqana Allahu wa iyaakum. And we thank our guests, our brother Fareed and Abu Muhammad, jazakum Allahu khayran, you know, for taking the time to come and benefit us with these words, and likewise Abu Hassan, jazakum Allahu khayran, and also our guests, the brothers, many brothers from Florida, from all over the US. Alhamdulillah, a sign that the da'wah is growing. And we hope that in those areas, likewise Kansas City, Missouri, we're not going to forget you, Muhammad. Jazakumullah khairan. But in Florida, Akhuna Sharif, with these brothers in these areas, they require people to go and teach. To teach the people, give khutbah, teach Quran, teach the Arabic language. One person can't do everything on his own. نعم وسبحانك وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.